Hi, and welcome to 3-Minute Adobe. In this video, we're looking at the functions of some of the settings in the noise reduction process in Adobe Audition. This video is just informational. To learn how to use the noise reduction process, click the link to the tutorial video in the description and then come back to this one to adjust the advanced settings. With the noise reduction dialog box open, in the first video, we use the default preset and capture noise print to take our sample of the noise that we're trying to remove. This graph below shows the frequencies captured in your noise print on the horizontal x-axis and the amplitude or volume of these frequencies on the vertical y-axis. In this print, you can see the lower frequencies are slightly louder than the higher ones. To adjust individual frequencies, you can add points along this line and drag them up or down to get the desired effect. The scale here, and I'll just reset that with this button over here. The scale here is either linear or logarithmic. This option is showing the same information in different ways. The linear evenly spaces the frequencies along this graph, good for working with high frequency reduction. The logarithmic, however, changes the scale to better resemble how humans hear sound. This gives you more detailed control over the lower frequencies by spreading them out on the scale. The noise reduction is the percentage of the noise print you're trying to remove, and the reduce by just below that is how many decibels you want this percentage to be reduced by. The output noise only box, when ticked, plays back the noise that will be removed. It's a good idea to tick this and listen because you'll be able to hear how much of the good noise, in this case the dialogue, is being taken out of your clip. For example, if I turn my sliders all the way back up here and play back a section.
In the background is an air conditioner, and we will look at how to remove that in this tutorial.
You can hear part of my voice there is being removed by the effect. Adjusting your sliders while this is turned both on and off is a good method to find a balance. This process is about finding the compromise between removing the bad and preserving the good. The spectral decay rate here under the advanced settings is how quickly after a good noise stops, the effect will push the background noise to silence. You would think that quickest is best, but if you have a small gap in a sentence between words or for a breath, this pushes the audio to silent really quickly after one word, but almost immediately back up when you start talking again. This can make the audio sound bubbly or like it's pulsating and can really degrade the quality. Adobe recommends leaving this between 40 and 75%. Smoothing over here helps smooth this effect where different frequencies fluctuate in volume in the noise you're trying to remove. Think about the noise at a party. Because of all the different people talking, there are a lot of frequencies fluctuating at different volumes. Increasing the smoothing will prevent bubbly audio again, but means the background noise will have to stay a bit louder. Again, this is about compromise. For beginners, leaving the precision factor and transition width at their defaults is best. The Fft size controls how many individual frequency bands are analyzed for the noise print capture. Increasing this can be slower, but provides more detail. This print that we've taken here is at 4096, and I'll swap this back to linear so we can see that there. Now if I change this to 512, and I'll retake a sample with the capture noise print up here, you'll see that the graph is showing a lot less frequencies here now to work with. This will depend on your individual file and computer power. That's the main settings a beginner might work with to remove noise. Click on the playlist in the description for more. This has been 3-Minute Adobe. Thanks for watching.